Hello, Dashi here, with a simple guide on Cheat Engine for Dark Souls 3. I'm going to teach you how to use scripts on the public table, such as itemgib and bonfire warp. Like anything else, Cheat Engine is a tool that can be used for good or for bad. It can be used to set up characters within minutes, so that you don't have to waste time grinding the game. Can CE ban you? Yes and no. The scripts I show in this video are all 100% safe. First things first, if you don't already have Cheat Engine installed, you're going to want to install it from cheatengine.org. Press the incredibly obvious green button. It looks like it'll give you a virus, but it won't. And then download the latest public table for Dark Souls 3. The table will be in a RAR file that you'll have to extract. Now, go through the simple installation process for Cheat Engine. You can hit No if you don't want to install additional software. Once that's done, and once you have the table, double-click the table to open it. This is what Cheat Engine looks like. You're going to want Dark Souls open in the background, with the character you want changes made to loaded in. Click the monitor icon in the corner and attach Dark Souls EXE. Itemgib will be under Helpers. The other script that is commonly recommended by other YouTube guides, itemswap, is not safe. It will ban you and anyone who picks up the items that have been swapped. Itemgib is the safe option. This is a list of all the items that are safe to spawn using itemgib, and items that are not. Be sure to spawn in the correct upgrade level and infusion for items. For example, Gale's greatsword only goes up to plus 5, not plus 10. Gale's can't be infused, so it'll be a normal infusion. If you don't know the upgrade level you want, it's good to simply spawn it in plus 0 and use a free upgrade script I'll show you later that will always let you reinforce and infuse legitimately. If you've created a character that hasn't upgraded anything at all, for example a new character, be sure to upgrade at least one weapon manually in-game. Spawning a plus 10 if you just started and haven't upgraded will mess up your matchmaking, and you'll be wondering why you can't find PvP. After you've chosen your item and the correct levels, hit spawn, and the item will go directly into your inventory in-game. Generally speaking, if the item can be traded, it can be spawned. All spells can be spawned as well as Estus shards and Undead Bone shards. For people who don't want to wait years to farm Covenant rewards, such as Darkmoon Blade, you can easily spawn the Miracle as well. Years of farming deleted. For consumables, you can spawn any quantity you want in-game. This is generally how people get unlimited Sieg Bros. Occasionally, you might get Shadow Realmed by another user, or you want to teleport to any bonfire in the game without actually having to progress through the game. Under Helpers, Bonfire Warp can take you to any bonfire in the game and remove you from the Shadow Realm. Just pick the bonfire you want to go to, and then hit Warp. Finally, this is how to upgrade your weapons without having to farm for Titanite, as upgraded materials is one of the things that is generally unsafe to spawn. Under Parampatris All IDs, you'll find a script called Upgrades Need No Materials. Select that, and you can upgrade Ed Andre freely without needing Titanite. Okay, final notes. Does any of this have to be done offline? No. It doesn't matter if you do this online or offline. If you do something that is bannable offline, the moment you hop online again, you'll get banned anyway. Are bans permanent? Yes. Once you get banned, you can appeal the first time ban if you email Bandai Namco directly, but any subsequent bans after that, you cannot appeal and it will be permanent forever. Hopefully this helps out some beginners and clears up some misunderstandings about CE. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye bye.